He is the best leader in Counter-Strike, in current Counter-Strike at the moment. People who have played under him as well.
Well, he's got this kind of all or nothing type of approach to the way he leads the team. Mm. You're either there, and I think it was, I can't remember who it was telling me this yesterday. Basically, you're either there practicing 24/7 and, yeah. and you're dedicated to this,
yeah.
or you're not in his team.
Yeah.
So you either want to be the best, or you don't, is where it's. And that doesn't always work with some people. Anyway, here we go, pistol round. And it will be Dignitas to start on the CT side, as you mentioned. Kyan, take us away.
Okay, here we go. We've got Neo, who's going to be the first casualty of the round. Taz heard someone in CT spawn. He's going to make his way on top of this A bomb site. Knows there's someone at long, pulling that trigger towards Zipnix, but he will somewhat get away with his life. But look who it is. It's Dupree from behind. Good shot from Bayali. And it's now 4 versus 4. Device and AZ team up together. And this is what we were talking about, Stu. They push as a team. They push as a unit. No one's pushing in one by one. Dignitas trying to retake this bombsite, but it's not going in their favor at the moment. AZ making it. AZ peasy lemon squeezy. He's only got two more to deal with. Snacks is going to go aggressive. Exactly what the Poles are known for. And well, they can't find him. They're both hiding in the smoke. They're playing Ringa Ringa Roses as the bomb ticks down. And Snacks wins it for the Poles, 1-0.
Great play, and that's exactly what the doctor ordered for Virtus Pro. Not sure whether we want to comment on AZ Peasy Lemon Squeezy. You know that the cheese factor on that one was
I like that
was high, like even by my stands. I thought I was cheesy, but no, as Virtus Pro are. It's exactly what they needed. You know, everyone is slightly afraid of Dignitas,
yeah,
because of the way that they've just dominated this tournament to date, and moments like that will give them belief, particularly players like Snacks being able to warm up and show that they've got what it takes. There were definitely concerns over their performance against London Conspiracy, mm-hmm. That certainly worried the VP loyalist in you, but we'll see whether they've got what it takes. It's a CZ round from Dignitas. We're on board with Taz. Virtus Pro now begin to make their entry with Pasha up towards that A site. Dupree gets himself a frag onto Taz elsewhere, and Pasha decides he's got to come in and help his team out here, because Dignitas have quickly assembled a 3-frag advantage. It stopped in the end, but there's only 2 men left up for VP. As it'll be Device who comes in with the next, and that CZ on a map like Dust with the angles they create with it just is impenetrable at times.
Yeah, and a lot of people still say, despite the fact that Valve nerfed it, it's still very, very overpowered. And the fact that Team Dignitas managed to win that all-CZ round up against Virtus Pro, who had the big rifles in hand, it's completely stomped Virtus Pro's economy. And to be fully honest with you, Stu, so far this tournament, we've seen a heck of a load of teams actually win their eco rounds. And it really has been surprising. But here we go.
Definitely become a feature of CSGO.
Yeah, yeah, a lot more than CS Source and CS 1.6, definitely. But here we go, 1-1, even Steven. Device has the Galil at mid. Bayali is going to make his way out there. Device spraying and praying through the doors. But another change in CSGO, they replaced the wooden doors with metal doors. Again, another decision that not a lot of people agree with. So, Device gets first blood onto Snacks. Zipnix is going to try and hold the A bombsite, but good shot from Taz with that P250. In hand. Device is the man who went down, and Zipnix now is going to try and hold the A bomb site. He's done it before, and if you ask me, I think he'll do it again. He has the weapon advantage, he has the Galil in hand, but Bayali has somehow made his way into the B bomb site. AZ drops him, and at 4 versus 2, when you consider the weapon advantage that Team Dignitas have here, it should be a simple round for them. So Pasha, last man standing. Zipnix knows exactly where he is. And surely, with 35 seconds to go, it's only going to be a matter of time until they manage to drop him. And there we go, the P90 comes out. Dignitas, a 2-1 up.
Very small thing there from Pasha. It was Zipnix who was up against, and as Zipnix reloaded, Pasha knew that was his time to chase him, get a close-range frag with the CZ. But Zipnix, to his credit, the moment he knew that reload was coming, retreated quickly, quickly, quickly out of sight, around the box and behind, and had another teammate coming from behind. Really, really small thing, but it just didn't give away, you know, what would be one. He wouldn't have got all 4 kills, you'd assume. But a small thing to do right, that Dignitas happened to do all of the small things right. You know, there hasn't been a round like what Dignitas just did to VP, which was they haven't given away any eco rounds. They've always been able to claim those back. And Dignitas will be buoyed with confidence, and this on the backdrop, of course, of saying that VP would be over the moon having won that pistol, but hasn't been that way, and the Danes are flying here with what looks like to be 5 unanswered frag. It's Bjarli left up as he makes his way through the smoke, and AZ has a clear shot on him. 7 frags for Dupree already in those opening 4 rounds. Thus far, for me, Dupree's probably been the player of the tournament, rivaled only by Kenny S.
Yeah, I have to agree with that one. He's been playing brilliant Counter-Strike based on what we've seen so far. Kenny S as well, that 3-versus-1 clutch in that final round up against virtus.pro, coincidentally, on Mirage. But here we go. Pasha finally has his favorite weapon in hand, the big green gun in the AWP. Trying to get a frag down mid, but he's not going to get it. Dupree is going to rotate over to the B bomb site, and Team Dignitas are going to play with 2 in the B bomb site. And there is the first AWP kill for Team Dignitas. They do have a 2-round lead, and as things stand at the moment, they're edging closer and closer to yet a 4th round. Device, the man of the hour. But here we go. Zipnik still has the Galil in hand. He's going to be the person to hold mid. And we can see Dupree to his right-hand side. He's facing the B bomb site because he's facing that wall that's right in front of him. If a mid to B push were to occur, Dupree would throw that flash up against the wall. It would pop flash at mid, and technically, or any virtus.pro players pushing through double doors would just find themselves completely flashed and blind. And as a CT, you want your opponents to face you when they're blind, because it should result in a simple frag. But here we go, Device, he's gotten 1 already this round, but he's now got snacks to try and deal with. Pasha, the normal virtus.pro AWPer, he was of course downed by this very man on your screens right now. But virtus.pro picking up the bomb, 3 of them on short and 1 person in lower. So we could see some sort of fake come over towards the A bomb site, smokes and flashes being thrown, and then they might fall back towards mid to B and try and push the B bomb site. And they have done. Taz, as a matter of fact, was the player to jump all the way down short towards CT spawn. Dupree gets 1, Device gets his 2nd. Great shot from Bjarli, straight through tunnels. Device gets the return frag. He's on 3 so far, and Bjarli finds himself in a 2-versus-1 situation. 4 seconds on the clock, but he only needs 3 to plant the bomb, but he is surrounded. Device knows, as a matter of fact, it was Fetish to drop him. And great stuff from the Dignitas leader.
Yeah, nice work there from virtus.pro to get something out of that round. A bomb plant, you know, the best they could have hoped for, given that they lost the opening frag and had made a very late pivot up towards that B attack. And bomb plant, the perhaps best of a bad situation. But Dignitas have started like they ended their last game, a steam train that shows no sign of stopping. And Device this time wielding the AWP. What's even more interesting is that, you know, Device on Dust is an awesome AWPer, but they still have Fetish, who was exceptional with that AWP earlier on as well. So Fetish and Zipnix both picked themselves up the kills. Fetish will follow on to Snacks, and it was an AK round for virtus.pro, but they're down to just 2 guns left in the game. As Taz gets himself the headshot onto Dupree. The CVP with the bomb now making their way up into Device's territory. As he waits for the first to show, and he does, and in towards A they go. As Device lies in wait, as he's pushed back by Bjarli, who continues to chase him out and follows it up with a headshot. Now Zipnik's going to have to deliver, and boy does he. First hit connects, and he and Fetish combine to down Bjarli, and that will be 5-1 Dignitas.
Yep, 5-1 Dignitas, and let's bear in mind that this is meant to be a somewhat slightly T-sided map, and Team Dignitas, I can't remember who it was, I think it was Anders and Henry who were talking earlier on about Team Dignitas just being that team, or it could have been on the analysis desk. They are that CT team.
Yeah, they're just a CT biased team.
You just don't want to face them when they're playing as counter-terrorists. And they're honestly just like one massive solid rock all over the bomb site. But here we go. virtus.pro are going to be ecoing. That bomb has been dropped, but I'm not sure if Dupree will actually spot it through the smoke. virtus.pro, they're going to continue going towards the A bomb site, but they don't have the bomb. Device drops Taz, and surely now virtus.pro will just find themselves outnumbered, and they only have pistols up against M4s, and really, I really expect Dignitas to just take out the trash here. Snacks, he's going to try and pick up the bomb. I think it's only a matter of time until he falls to his death. There we have it. Easy for Dignitas.
Really great play from Dig thus far. You know, you can argue when you look at that VP attack, you know, we've been in eyes on VP most of the time, on Dignitas most of the time, but if you look at the way VP have played, they've tried to mix it up as best they can. They have been able to move players around, but when they've had the AWP in the hands of Pasha, he hasn't been able to open up a site for them. And that's been the big part. The few rounds that they've had, and they have had enough gun rounds, but they haven't been able to get that first kill with Pasha that then allows them to move a strat or force someone to move. What's happened is exactly what you've just seen. It's Device gets the kill, and now look, he's going to retreat all the way back in towards that site because he knows that now that they've got that first man, doesn't matter where they come, they fancy their chances, they fancy the numbers into whichever site VP may go. And he has barely put a foot wrong in this map, Device. It'll be Pasha now who will have to equalize up the numbers, but again, there's no one there for him. There's no angle, and they know that there's an AWP on that VP side, and as a result, they've hidden themselves into hard-to-find angles for an AWPer. Now they've got an opportunity here as they can move him into position to take on the wall. It'll be Dupree who goes for the first. Zipnix helps him out, and that's brilliant. They had a man on the door. They had a man come through the hole and from spawn, and as the four players came through the double doors, they were walking into a trap, as Admiral Akbar might have said.
It's a trap. But I was quite surprised to see Pasha with the AWP join his teammates and push him towards mid to B. Maybe it would have been a more intelligent decision to just go for the full AK setup like they have done here. They've more or less got full flashes, bar Pasha, who of course bought the AWP in the last round, which will have hurt his economy slightly more than the rest of his teammates. Fetish has been pot flashed towards long. Spot stacks, sprays through the doors, but he's not going to be able to take him out, but he has left him hurt severely on only 25 points of health. The bomb dropped at mid. Zipnix and Dupree try and hold off what could potentially be and what will be a mid to B push. Taz is going to go down to Zipnix, who's just holding that trigger and going absolutely Rambo at B ramp. Dupree now needs to try and hold them off. He goes down to Pasha. Look who it is. Terrific spray down from Zipnix. Neo now, 1 versus 4. I doubt he'll be able to do anything, or have I spoken too soon? 1 versus 3 now as Team Dignitas play a patient game on B ramp. They know they have the bomb. They know that they need to run this clock down. And as long as Neo can't pick up the bomb, virtus.pro can't win the round. Unless Neo goes sick and just manages to somehow drop the three of them. So here we go. He's going to keep them. And, well, Device does what Device does best.
It was a great call there. They realized that they didn't need to engage with Neo. Yeah. Neo, they were mid-fight Neo amongst the adrenaline. They realized where the bomb was, and they're like, ah, he's isolated from it. We can fall back quickly, get Device in a great position, and from that moment on, Neo was always playing with fire. Team Dignitas doing what they've done all weekend long, and that is destroy their opponents. I mean, I was talking to Fetish before the game, and I said, look, you're going to have to make this a little more exciting for us. You're just going to have to, like, somehow slow it down or mix it up. Just throw in something for us. And he wasn't amused. Device with that AWP. So, 10 frags are the good thus far, and looks to make it 11. Not to be this time, but he does have intel, and he says that the virtus.pro players are coming up the ramp, and it'll be Taz and Neo, the stalwarts of this side, who bait their entry. They're all huddled up, and they're going to make their move. Once the Molotov has passed, surely, it'll be Nax watching the rear. That nade comes in. Tickles Bialy, Taz down to 46 points of health as well. Device has taken damage, but all of those BP players are tagged. And now it'll be Zipnix tossing into the soon-to-be oncoming BP attack. And here it is! Taz gets the first frag. Device down, and now it'll be Zipnix to have to hold on to this situation. They know he's there, and they, in the end, get the kill onto him, courtesy of Taz. AZ and Dupree both go down, and Fetish knows when his game is up, and they get away with four men that round VP as well. Vital for them to have done that, as they will go into this with weapons and close out. VP have their second round on the board, but it's absolutely critical for them that they make that two in a row. Otherwise, the money system will reset against them.
Exactly, they need to make it count. And by the looks of things, yeah, Bialy is going to get an AK-47. So they're going to go with the same thing. Their money, like you said, is still very, very, very low. So they really need to win these back-to-back rounds. And you know what? They're capable of doing it. We saw what they're capable of doing at Katowice. Team Dignitas, they've improved a lot recently. But with Virtus Pro and their really, really aggressive in-your-face style, you just never know what will happen on the day. But here we go. Dupree is AWPing mid. Virtus Pro are toying with him at the moment. But that smoke is going to prevent him from getting any potential kills. Max is going to boost himself onto short whilst Neo makes a little bit of noise. And this is the thing about the Virtus Pro approach at the moment. They love to take mid control. They love to just wait it out. They want to try and see if Team Dignitas will push them. They want to see if they can get the entry frag, and build on it. But the problem with Team Dignitas is they're just a solid rock. They sit on top of the bomb site, and you try to come anywhere near them, boom, before you know it, a bullet between your two eyes. And you find yourself spectating the rest of your teammates. But anyways, here we go. It looks like they are going to try for the A-bomb site, where I believe they had a bit of success previously. I think it was on one of the pistol rounds. But Zipnix, however, is going to rotate round towards CT spawn, where he, as a matter of fact, had Neo right behind him. But he is going to get absolutely surrounded. Good kill from Neo, arguably one of the best CS 1.6 players in the world, and wants to show us why he thinks he's one of the CSGO best players in the world. But at the moment, Dignitas, they're just shutting Virtus Pro down, and they're making it look easy. Or have I spoken too soon? I think I may have done fetish. Here's the bomb going down. Stax needs to turn around. He's being shot up his backside, and with only 10 seconds to go, fetish, he just has to run away. He has to hide, because if Stax drops him now with 4 seconds remaining, they will lose the round. Fetish has got his trainers on. He's running away, and Team Dignitas somehow managed to salvage that all-important ninth round. And Stu, they prevented Virtus Pro from building on that momentum, from building on that second round they got.
Yeah, I'm actually a little lost as to how Snax didn't plant that bomb. Mm. You're waiting to hear the word bomb has been planted as he's putting it down, and somehow he's got up. I wonder whether it was like a second too soon. He just assumed it would come in and started moving, or it was intentional and they thought they could take Fetish. But Fetish saving the round there, really beyond belief. And for VP's perspective, they only got away with one gun as well. So, tough to take for Virtus Pro. And it just builds into this Dignitas story that they are oh so dominant. And it was interesting to watch against NIP, and I'd be very curious as to what the analyst desk's opinion of this is. Against NIP, they were playing against a very reactionary team. You know, the NIP sat and they tried to find a pick, and they tried to find a hole, and then they would make their decisions based off that. They didn't run particular set strats. Against VP, they're playing against this set strat, but with flair players who can unlock things on their own. And at the moment, they've got an answer for every type of CS that you can throw at them. As VP, very heavy on A. They've only gone B, I think, twice in these 11 rounds. And, well, Device is going to get himself one onto Taz. Looks for the second, but Pasha will prevent that. As Device does his job, though, did slow down that defense once more, but it's Bialy who says, we will pick up speed once more. Neo's got the back covered. Dispatches of AZ, and bomb planted with only Dupree left standing. And this would be VP's third round of the board. And Dupree will just want to make it as expensive as possible, but it's not to be, and he escapes. Look at the scoreboard there. Dupree at 12. He's been on the top of the board, I would say, for most of Dignitas' game. Device with that AWP. Slowed down in the past few rounds, but also leading the way. And on the other side, Pasha hasn't shown up yet. Just three frags, but a four-frag split from Pasha up to Bialy. It's not been a great round. And we talked at the beginning about Dignitas playing well together, despite there not being much of a B push. The B players are only three frags behind the A players, which shows you how quickly they get into defend as a team when it happens.
Yeah, and most importantly as well, they rotate as a team. The two B players, when they want to rotate, they flash each other out. They say, I'll flash you out, and you can then push. That way they avoid, for example, because if Virtus Pro assign someone the get right flanking role, they could get done from behind. But Team Dignitas, they've got each other covered. And we saw that when Virtus Pro tried to go into the A bomb site. We saw Device drop, and before they knew it, there was another person, I think, in Fetish along with the M4. So they dispose of one, and before they know it, there's another Team Dignitas player on their tails. But it is going to be one of the poles to get the first blood frag. Snax with the AK-47 headshot onto Dupree. Device up in mid, down goes Pasha, who you said hasn't really shown up so far. But you never know, there's still a few more rounds to play in the rest of this half, so we're just going to have to wait and see. Device. Still with that big, what's normally a big green gun, but in the recent updates, it's most commonly turned into a big white and orange gun. Device falling back towards a B bomb site, and now Team Dignitas. Device is going to hold B ramp from inside a window, and I think they've just swapped round. So we're going to have Device with the AWPer, watching towards tunnels, and AZ with the M4 watching towards B ramp, while Zipnix is going to sit on A ramp, all eyes on short, and Fetish is going to be the man to try and protect long as the terrorists make their way up towards this A bombsite. Zipnix gets one, but one is not going to be enough. Device now and AZ find themselves in a very, very hard position. They're both going to try, no, one's going to try and rotate through CT, and the other's going to try and get himself on short. And at 3 versus 2, this is still doable. The retake is on. We saw some phenomenal retakes from London Conspiracy earlier on in the tournament, particularly on Inferno. And when you consider that, Neo and co. are actually towards long. That's exactly what the doctor ordered for Dignitas. AZ, he gets the headshot onto Neo. Device is going to smoke out the bomb. He needs to start defusing. He has a kit. The defuse timer is ticking. Snax is going to try and knife him, but oh, the defuse comes in. And well, virtus.pro tried to mess around. It looked like Snax wanted to knife him. But the thing is, you try to mess around, you try to get cocky, and a team like Dignitas will make you pay the price.
I don't know if that was messing around or that was just, you know, good luck for Dignitas. I mean, yeah, playing down the smoke was really good. I was ready to compliment VP's afterplant setup in the way they had those three players there. But it didn't work for them. And that's just one of those things that didn't just get the rub of the green. You can see Famous is out from them here, though. They've got the full nade complement, but not a full weapon complement for this round. But they have a 7-round advantage. 10 rounds on the CT side here on Dust is more than enough, and that's not to say they can't get two more. Device to see action as Neo comes in. Device picks up the first. Can he get the second? Quickly gets that AK, waits for Taz to come towards him. Can he get the second? Great play from Device there. Not only did he slow down that attack, but he got two kills. He's more than earned his cheese today as he will fall back, and it'll be Zipnix to take on the barrier. AZ pushes out, gets himself that kill onto Bialy, and it's Pasha and Snax versus 4. Zipnix makes that versus 1, all on Pasha, who is isolated down in A long. They know he's there, and none, well, I was about to say none of them are going to show, but absolutely they are. They're going to get the kill as well. So Dignitas pick themselves up round number 11, and they're just making this look easy.
And the thing about virtus.pro, because of this Team Dignitas defense, because of the way they set up, virtus.pro, they just can't get a break. We saw virtus.pro drop Fetish at long, and then before they knew it, a few seconds later, Zipnix was actually waiting for them at the corner. So they dispose of one, they think, right, let's push long, and hang on a second, Zipnix is there as well. And that's what makes Team Dignitas so solid in their CT setups. They're always backing each other up, and like you said earlier on, Stu, they work as a team. They all work as a unit. So Zipnix is going to fall back, retreat, and group up with the rest of his teammates. He doesn't want to get taken out on short by himself. I think virtus.pro will have smoked mid, and his teammates will have told him that. So he took the intelligent decision to fall back and play the A bomb site with the other two teammates he has on this A bomb site. The bomb is on short. Dupree with a very interesting setup here. I'm not sure if he's planning on flashing this or smoking it. Bialy and Neo have somehow managed to creep and make their way in towards CT spawn. It's going to be Device to get the first frag onto Snax. He might get more if he can just avoid the fire of hell on short. And yes, he can. He will get 4. Out comes the CZ. He couldn't make it 5. But credit where it's due to Device. Brilliant round from him.
Had a brilliant half from Team Dignitas there. And Device, you got to pick out there, because not only were the AW, he basically played 2 quarters in that half. So the first quarter he had the AWP, and he was scouting for intelligence, and he was always getting the first hit. Not always the first kill, but he was always getting the first hit. And in the opening kind of 7 rounds, he was leading the scoreboard. And then it slowed down for him. The AWP wasn't working. but he was more than happy to change up, more than happy. He didn't have that stubbornness that some AWPers have that says, well, it's CT side, so I'm the AWPer and I must always have an AWP. No, he was more than comfortable changing that up. Snacks picked off by Fetish from afar there on the headshot, and that's just a sign of how good Dignitas have been, that they can claim that kill. They did lose Device momentarily, right as I'm waxing lyrical about his performance, but they'll look to close this out because well, if you go all the way back to just kind of give you how much confidence is in this team, virtus.pro, of the three rounds they won, the first was the pistol round. And that was instantly nullified by a great CZ round from Team Dignitas. It was a five-man clear out with that CZ round. But now BP will struggle to hold on to that A site. Dupree is going to push out Bialy. Taz does in the end get a kill, but it's AZ onto Taz. It's Neo left, 1 versus 3. He's worried about what's to his right. He's worried about what's to his left. And in the end, he's cut down from both sides. High fives all around. And this Dignitas side are moving on quickly. They got one hand on this map already.
Yeah, they do. They only need 3 more rounds to emerge 1-0 up in this best of 3. And the second map, if my memory serves me correct, will be Cash. And Cash is always an interesting map to cast because it's all about the mid control. And I think it'll be really interesting to see how both these teams actually fare on it. I'm not sure if I've ever seen them both play on Cash against each other before, but here we go. Dignitas wasting no time, because they're gonna stampede straight into this B bomb site. Neo shuts one down. AZ's trying to spray through the doors. Device gets a kill with a P90. And well, the Poles, they're just stuck with small, tiny USPs here. And at 4 versus 2, when the terrorists have Galils, when the terrorists have P90s, I really can't see them winning this one. And there you go, 14-3.
14-3, Dignitas looking awesome, and you know, they have the potential to go all the way in Cologne as well. They're gonna stake their flag down here, and unless Titan can do anything about it, they're gonna stake their flag down and say, we have been consistent throughout this tournament, which is the one thing no team have done. And that is just a unique, well, Pasha with the anti-Henry G weapon, we'll call it now, the scout, he does hate it. And we'll come back to the point of consistency, because it's something you rarely see in tournaments these days. As Neo cleans up and VP do get themselves on the board, in the end it does work well for them. And Zipnix is out, and this crowd rise to give them a round of applause. And virtus.pro, they have the crowd on their side. People are wanting to see a game, and Dignitas thus far have shut it down.
Yeah, they have done, 14-4. I mean, virtus.pro need 10 more rounds to even things out, let alone win the game. So there's still a long, long way back up a very, very steep hill on this less favored CT side on DDoS2 for virtus.pro to try and climb. But hey, we know they're capable of doing it. But Team Dignitas, they now find themselves on an eco. They find themselves with only the CZ-75s, and it looks like they are going to go towards mid to B. Neo got a spray down last time round. Unfortunately, though, this time only managing to get one, and Taz and Bialy are going to go big in trying to annihilate these Team Dignitas players. But at the moment, it looks like it's going to be them who are going to annihilate virtus.pro. The bomb has gone down. Zipnix has picked up an M4. I'm surprised he hasn't actually dropped it to Device, but whatever floats his boat at the end of the day, I guess. Pasha is going to throw that smoke through the doors. Bialy close by. Down goes Device, but wait, no, it's not Device who went down. It's Zipnix. Device now on the clutch is going to try and take something out of Snax's book. Snax is going to try and no-scope him. Device is going to pick up that AK-47, and oh, Dignitas going to win the eco round. No, they're not. Dearie me, what on earth happened there? I was confused whilst trying to explain what on earth happened. Device got the double with the CZ-75 out of nowhere. I thought he was the one who went down, and then they were trying to knife each other.
Well, he ran out of ammo, and that's why he ran over towards that AK, but it had just 9 bullets left in it. And yeah, awesome stuff there. And Snacks in the end coming out on top, but virtus.pro were just moments away. Well, of course, all the time whilst Device is, you know, occupying Snacks, that bomb ticker is getting, you know, closer and closer to the detonation. So they were on 2 levels. Device was oh so close from winning that round for Team Dignitas, but back to the drawing board they go. And of course, bomb plant and 4 frags on an eco or a CZ round is nothing to undervalue. Fetish with that AWP on the T side. Let's see what he can do. He's going up against his opposite number in Snacks, but it's Neo that he's caught sight of. And if EPR to build some momentum, it's going to have to come right here. If they can pick off this attack, then they will force a save. Pasha will be alert to the danger that is coming towards him now as the Dignitas side flash him out. He has to wait for this one. The smoke does its job perfectly. Pasha can't see anyone, and when he does, he comes out firing. Two frags of Pasha. Neo and Snacks both have one as well, and Zipnix is the only man left standing. Not a frag on the board for Dignitas that time around, and that is just what the doctor ordered for virtus.pro. They do not look that chuffed, but that is the only way they're going to get back into this one.
Yeah, people are clapping, and rightly so. Brilliant play from Pasha. We said we haven't really seen him step up based on what we've seen so far, but if there was ever a better time for him to step up, I can't think of a better time than now. Team Dignitas only two rounds away from winning. They're now on an eco. The last time they ecoed, we saw what happened on top of that B-bomb site, but hopefully virtus.pro will be able to eradicate it as they are going to push straight into the B-bomb site. Neo is spraying and praying. Neo gets the triple. No, it was the quad kill. And well, it was up against eco, but that spray control, it's not easy at all, Stu.
It's not, but Dignitas trying to make stuff happen for themselves on those eco rounds, and you can commend that. You're up against it. Not every round can be as close as their last one, but now we're back onto another gun round for Team Dignitas, and they know that one can quickly become two, and that will be the game. Or the map. Snacks rattles off his AWP shot, and those last two rounds, getting all of those kills, I think they got 10 unanswered kills. It will have not only boosted the coffers, but it will have boosted the morale on that VP side. It would be a miraculous comeback, but they might just feel a little more confident about it now. Device gets himself that kill onto Pasha, though, and that might just open up the A site for them as he waits for reinforcements. They just haven't actually committed anything. They're more than happy to say, Device, go do your job, and then we'll decide in a second, and that's exactly what they're doing. They're moving that attack through now, double doors as Taz will see action. He's got reinforcements coming in the shape of Neo. Neo waits to see how many, gets only the first. Taz comes in with the second, but Zipnix is going to go for both of those two kills. Neo and Taz down, Zipnix the victor, and he will charge on in towards that B site with the help of Fetish, and it will be a 2-on-3. Snacks and Bialy, the two up for virtus.pro here. And they will have to be joined at the hip to reclaim this site. Look on the mini-map for the placement of AZ as well. He's not going to be immediately visible, but he will play a larger role here as the nades come in over the wall, and it'll be Snacks to go through, and oh, there wasn't even a hope of that happening. Dignitas shut it down, and they hit 8 map points, and the one Dignitas fan in the crowd claps.
The one Dignitas fan. Well, it's nice to know that we have a Dignitas fan. It's the first time we hear him.
Could have been Odie. Was it you, Odie, doing the clap? No, it wasn't. There was someone else. And I don't think anyone is particularly anti-Dignitas. They just want to see good CS. They just want to have, you know, these two players entertaining them as best they can.
Oh, good way from Fetish to introduce himself into this round. And it could be the Team Dignitas winning round. Pasha has been spotted on short. He's going to fall back as he leaves that smoke there to act as a bit of a decoy, but the Team Dignitas lads do find themselves two men up, but Taz wants to put an end to that. He sprays and prays through double doors, doesn't deal too much damage, and now Pasha has got to try and guess through these smokes, gonna try and see if he can get an AWP kill through them, but he's not gonna be able to. Dupree somehow through the smoke drops Pasha, 5 versus 2. It's gonna take a miracle, surely, for Taz and Bialy to potentially not just save this round, but of course, lose this round, you lose the map, and you find yourselves 1-0 down in the context of the game. AZ, boom headshot, and Bialy now has it all to do. 5 versus 1 clutch, and it's not gonna happen. And Team Dignitas, I don't know whether it'd be fair to say that it was a one-sided game.
Well, I think it was pretty emphatic from Team Dignitas, and it was kind of just right that on the one match point they had, they won it with 5 unanswered kills. Dignitas look like they have